started this initiative and what all things will be there. So let me start with that. So there are some of the things which I would like to talk about with you, that the issues. Okay, so there are certain issues which you as a student face. First issue is in first is inconsistency. And we are so much involved in this issue that sometimes we think that why I'm not able to study, why I'm not able to study for like 5-6 days in a row. Okay, so this 5-6 days consistent study which we hear in the topper's talk that they used to study for such a great length, but when we see ourselves, we are like, why I'm not able to study for this? And we keep on punishing ourselves. Suppose you can study for 2 days. I'm not asking more than that. I'm just asking that can you study for 2 days in a row? I think any serious candidate, I'm not talking about the sincereness of anyone here. I think any serious candidate can study this much. Okay. So 2 days, can you study? Yes. Then second problem is we keep on planning. We are good planner, but worst executor. Just give me a second. We are good planner, but worst executor. So when it comes to the execution, we are worst. And we keep on blaming ourselves. Suppose you are able to study, let us say, in the month of Feb, you started from 1st Feb. Then 2nd Feb, you were able to study well. Then 3rd, 4th, 5th. You were not able to, like you were studying for 1st and 2nd Feb. Then you enter into the guilt cycle. You enter into the guilt cycle. And in that guilt cycle, you are not only wasting these 3 days, but next 3 or 4 days. Okay. So next 3 or 4 days. Then you keep on planning. That okay, let me change my plan. Let me see that how I'm going to study or what should I do. Then you might go for the topper's talk or you might go for, let us say, some motivational videos. Okay, so either the topper's talk or motivational videos. Then again, you start your preparation or let us say on 10th or 11th. Again, you are studying for 2 days only. So this guilt trap and this guilt planning is killing your initiative. Okay, so they are killing approximately 6 to 8 days in every 15 days. What if I say that it is okay, that let me accept that you can study only for 2 days? What is wrong with that? Because we have to accept, our human personality. We have to accept who we are, and if we are not able, and if we are not able to understand that it is okay to be like imperfect human being, then you enter into this guilt cycle all the time. And this guilt cycle keep on coming. Okay, so what is the solution for that? And why we have shared that this is a different kind of course, innovative as well as the most confused one. Why I have said it? Reason being, suppose I'm telling you that, okay, like tomorrow we are starting, and I'm telling you just study for 2 days, only for 2 days, then 1 day break, 1 day break, okay? So you don't have to study. Is it some kind of domestic violence or just a noise? Okay, after the session, you see that. So if I'll say that 2 day you study and then take 1 day full break. In that break, it depends on you. If you want to study your optional, or you don't want to study at all, then it is fine. What is the issue with that? Because even if we are consistently studying 2 days and taking 1 day break, then also those who have appeared in prelims like more than 2 times, they can finish their full prelim syllabus, and I can guarantee you for that. And of course I need your commitment. Of course I need that you should at least study for 2 days. I can guarantee you within 40 days, one time you will be able to finish your full prelim syllabus. And those who are new or like 0 or 1 attempt case, within 60 days, one time, you will be able to finish the syllabus of your prelims. Don't you think that it is great that we are accepting that, yes, I'm not able to study more like others, but despite of that, I can finish my syllabus if I'm falling in this category, minimum 2 prelims. Why this category is being created? Because I assume if you have appeared minimum 2 times in the prelims, then at least you have some rough idea about the subject. At least you have read Lakshmikant for minimum 2 times. So you will take less time than these guys, 0 and 1 wala case. So there is a hope that despite being inconsistent, you can finish if you are in category 2 in 40 days and 60 days. That is thing number one. Second thing is, as I have said about in the pro course, you might have seen there is a thing for answer writing. Why answer writing we have planned? These technologies. Why answer writing? Reason being, if you will see the mains paper, GS4 completely static, but of course it does not come in the prelim syllabus. Here we use some anecdote and some example from current affairs. But if you will see at GS1, around 80 to 85% static. You can check the paper. Then in GS2 and GS3, in the top of stop, you will hear that around 90% paper is of current affairs. Am I right? In GS2 and GS3, in the topper stop, you will always hear that around 90% paper is from the current affairs. But it is not the case. Around 70% question. Nowadays, around 70% question. 60 to 70% minimum are from static. So why can't we write some, why can't we do some answer writing at this point of time? What is harm in that? To write two answers on the topic which you have read in the morning, it will hardly take half an hour, 30 minutes. And this 30-minute exercise will help you when you will clear the syllabus. Because most of the syllabus from the static side. Am I audible? Audio is on, Garima.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So most of the syllabus, you will be able to finish before the prelim with some basic answer writing. And this basic answer writing will definitely help you post prelims, because post prelims, at least you have written like let's say that 100 or 110 answers, then you will not be worried about the answer writing. So that is why we have started this answer writing with this course. And if you will be able to write answer on the topics which you have read in the morning, I can guarantee you one thing, you will be at ease and you will be far, far better than others who have not done any answer writing before the prelim. And this answer writing will not harm you in any way. It will only supplement your preparation. Then, how we are going to proceed in this course? So first thing which we'll do, that is, we will give you topics which you are going to read for next 2 days. Tomorrow is 17, and then next day is 18. So we'll tell you that only these topics on 17th and 18th you have to finish. 19th is your off. Can't you finish these topics and the topics we have chosen on the basis of your number of attempts? Like there is one course for minimum 2 prelims, another is 0 or 1. So for this minimum 2 pre, if I'll ask you to finish, let's say, till fundamental rights, can't you do it? And there is no holistic plan. The beauty of this course is, and that is why I have said it is the most confusing course, the beauty of this plan, you don't know what I'm going to schedule on 20th and 21st. You don't know that. That I will tell you. And I cannot promise you that these topics will be from politics. I can't. But what I can promise you is that just 2-day schedule, and whatever schedule we have made, whatever plan we have made, it is being made over like 25 or 30 days. So the thinking part behind this plan, it was like 25, 30 days. So on 20th, on 21st, there is a possibility that you might be reading about 1857 revolt. There is a possibility that you might be reading about basic economy. There is a possibility you might be reading about biodiversity. So the whole plan is being prepared on that thinking, that like an ideal way. Okay, so suppose if we are living in an ideal world. So in the ideal world, I'll give you a schedule, a PDF. a PDF till pre. So you know what you are going to read on 20th and 21st, then there is break on 22nd again, what you are going to read on 23rd and 24th. So in your mind, and like our mind is the most faulty thing in the body, that is why we are so much worried about the selection, consistency and other. Then in your mind, you will settle this plan that, okay, till prelims, I'll have to do it. In this 40 days, I'll have to do it. So in your mind, you will be like, okay, even if I will not study on 20th and 21st, then I will get this break and I will settle all the things on 23rd. I will push myself and then you will make your own plan out of the whole PDF. But that never works. These whole PDFs are really available on so many websites and Telegram channels. Even we can share an ideal plan that how you should prepare for your prelims for two time pre or 011. But we have designed this course by keeping that thing in mind that we are not a normal or ideal. I would say we are normal, but we are not ideal human beings. So if we are telling you that you are in, like you have appeared twice in prelims, you have to finish till fundamental rights. Okay, then for 2 days, you can do it. That, okay, I can do it. Then there is a 1 day break. You can take the break. Can you imagine in any plan you are taking a break just after 2 days? But here we are allowing you. When you will be consistent with this plan, then you will change this 2 days to 3 days. Then we will change this 2 days to 3 days. And at most, we will change this 3 to 4. That is the last and the most optimum thing which I am expecting from you. But that will only come when we will start studying for 2 days initially. Then we are comfortable with three. In this three also, we will include 3 plus 2. Studying for 3 days, then break, then 2 days. So it will be like 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 3. So this is break, 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 break. Okay. So that is first thing. We'll give you the topics. Second thing is, second point is, around 20 questions. 20 questions from prelims we will share in the evening. Suppose today's topic was preamble, then constitution making process, or the feature of Indian constitution. So 20 questions you will get on the topics which you have read in the morning. Okay, so 20 questions you will get the topics in the morning, whatever you have read. So you are supposed to solve these 20 questions. And plus we will give you 2 questions. From main side on the topics which you have read in the morning itself. So in the night, when you will finish these topics, there are some who can finish these topics in like 3-4 hours. There are some who might take 6-7 hours. So it depends on your capability, and you don't have to punish yourself even if you are taking 8 hours. Don't worry. But these 2 exercises, this 20 question and 2 question, it must be followed by. only then you will be able to move in the right direction. So first is, we are going to give you topic, only 2 day topic we will give you, then 20 question we will give, then 2 question to write answer on that. So your day, so your ideal day would be finishing the topic. Second, solving pre-mock of 20 question. And third, writing to answer. This will be your ideal day. How many days? 2 days. Then take proper 1 day off. There is no harm in that. Are you getting it? What I'm trying to say? So ideally we will move like this. Then another thing is, that is third thing. Third is, SOMP support. We will keep on sharing some audio. Some audio message that how you should prepare for that particular topic, or Zoom session, those who will join. So by doing that, you will be motivated and you will be in the process. So this is how this plan will move on. So there is a surprise element. We will tell you the book list, everything which you are supposed to refer. So suppose on 17th, 18th, on 17th and 18th, policy topic, then Lakshmikant. But on 20th and 21st, suppose there is a topic on art and culture, or modern, or medieval, or ancient, then we'll tell you that from where to that. So your only job is to at least study for 2 days, and larger goal, as we have shared, those who are in course 2, minimum 2 pre, one time reading in 40 days. But this 40 days does not mean you might have seen that picture. Let me bring that picture in front of you. So someone might say that, sir, it's not 40 day duration. Of course it is not. But we are counting from the number of days you are going to study. So only 40 days study between 17th Feb and 10th Feb, we are expecting from you. Same goes for course 1, 60 days, 17th Feb to 10th May. Otherwise, roughly, if you will count, then this is like 84, roughly. And this is like 14. 24 and 55 days. But we are counting only the days when you are going to study. So from phase one, you will be able to finish your syllabus one time in such days and till this date. Then phase two is more about adding the current affairs and revision. And phase three is massive revision. Okay. So this is the thing which we have planned. And this mentorship thing and prelims test series thing, if you are confused, here you will get a proper mentor support. Here you will get a proper mentor support means one mentor will be allotted to you, a dedicated mentor to you, with whom you can talk whenever you face any issue, exam oriented or some personal or anything. So SOMP is known for mentorship. So you will get the mentor support here. Apart from this, in this, you will be added to a channel. There we will share your 2 days plan, then question on prelims, then question on mains. And there will be general sessions taken by us. Now, if anyone has any doubt, please feel free to ask. Anyone, unmute your audio and ask the doubts. Regarding this course, if anyone is having any doubt,
sir, will you cover current affair also in this course?
Yes, we will.
Okay, thank you.
We'll definitely cover current affairs. And as of now, SOMP prelims notes are now not out there. So for the current affairs, we are going to provide the current affairs notes of SOMP and we will provide you that. Any more doubts?
Sir, will we be able to choose the subject? Like, if I want to cover economics first or no, it will be decided by you.
Look, this is a general plan, where whatever I will say or I will share, you will have to follow that. In the mentorship, you can get the flexibility of choosing your own topics.
Okay.
So it will be general for all. Yes, Abhinav, you can join later. Yes, Prashant, you can. Garima, I will share the recording of this session. Just after.
So this is Juhi. What would be the first subject which we'll be dealing with?
Sorry?
What would be the first subject which we'll be dealing with?
First subject, that is the surprise element here. For 2 days, next 2 days, we are going to deal with quality. After that, there will be surprise. And of course, I can guarantee you after 2 days, means like 17th and 18th, we are going to deal with the quality. Then 19th is off. Then 20th and 21st. Quality will not be there. Some other things, and we will try that the topics which are tough for everyone, we should try to finish that first, because we have the habit of finishing simple topics at the first place. And like, suppose who is in their fourth or fifth attempt, they know that they have read Lakshmikant like 20-30 times minimum. But if I'll ask how many times you have covered the environment, how many times you have covered the, let's say, science and tech, they are like, sir, one or two times. Art and culture, sir, chhod hi diya. So we will try the tough topics we are going to finish earlier. And as we are starting with quality, so that is a simple topic, you can get the momentum to proceed.
Sir.
Yes.
I'm not able to understand the framework actually. Surprise element, as in, I mean, you'll be giving us 2 days.
Yes. So on 17th and 18th, we are going to cover polity. 19th is off. 20th and 21st, a different topic will be provided to you, and that will not be polity for sure.
Okay.
So that's surprise. So we are not giving the whole plan as of now. We will tell you only that, okay, on 17th and 18th, you are going to finish the polity, this and this topic. Then on 20th and 21st, there is a possibility we will ask you to finish architecture of art and culture. Or we might
ask... Today is 16th, and test would be on 17th, like tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow. Tomorrow we are starting.
So you're not giving us anything to prepare. I mean, there would be no framework for preparing.
Test? What kind of test?
Okay, I'm confused now.
Test means the prelims question you will get only when you will finish the topic. So suppose tomorrow you are finishing preamble, then constitutional development and other things in the morning. In the evening time, we will give you the question. So,
okay,
you read that topic in the morning and afternoon and evening. So, by night, you are able to solve those 15-20 questions from the prelims side, right? And on the same topic, we will give you two questions on mains. And we will check the copy of those questions.
Okay, okay.
I hope I have cleared your doubt.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you have.
Okay. Okay. Any more doubt? Yeah.
Sir, I have a doubt regarding which course to join, course 1 or 2, because sir, I have given only one attempt, but I am preparing since 3 years, and I have at least read all the subject 3-4 times. So I have doubt what to do.
Then I think you are suitable for course 2. Zero or one means that suppose you have read Lakshmikant only once, then it would become very difficult for you to cover Lakshmikant with the pay of the second one.
No, sir. I have at least read 3, 4, 5 times Lakshmikant. Yes.
Then I think you should go for course.
Okay.
Anyone else? Chandni, like whatever topics we are going to give, we are going to give as per the understanding that yes, others are going to write some exams. Some are going for state PSC, some are going for like IB is scheduled on 18th and RBI grade B. So we are not going to put a lot of pressure. So it will be like I'm expecting that like 5 hours if you are devoting for this course, then it is sufficient. Yes, working professional can join this course. Yes, so it's interesting that you don't know what is coming next. Utkarsh, as I have said, that only for 2 days, I'm going to tell you what you are going to finish. What you are going to finish. Then there is a break. And at least 5 hours, I'm expecting, or maximum 5 hours or minimum you can see according to your capabilities. So you can schedule your optional apart from that. But if you are going to join this course, anyone, those who are in this session, I request all of you that please do write the answers. I know all of you will solve the prelims portion. It is very easy. And some of you might not. So that would be your major loss. So prelims to karna hi hai. But mains, 2 questions every day you must write. That will give you the confidence. And if you are afraid of answer writing or anything, don't worry, we'll support you. We'll tell you how to go for that. But without writing answers, I think you will waste your money and time. Reason being, answer writing is very important. And at this point of time, like others are going for prelims, but from the core of my heart, I can tell you, real game is of mains. of course, many are not able to clear the prelims, and they think that if I'm not clearing the prelims, then what is the point of preparing for the mains? But you will get one chance to write the mains. And those who are struggling for 3, 4, 5 years to clear the prelims, you will get only one chance, a single chance to write the mains. And if you are not prepared for that, then you will miss it badly. Badly. So don't think that only and only prelims matters. Mains matters. And mains is the real game. And I like, we had a very good discussion with the students who have appeared in this year mains. You can check on our YouTube channel. There were some those who didn't clear prelims for 3 years or 4 years or 5 years. But when they appeared in mains, their experience, their things matter. You can see through their talk that how Topper's talk killed their hard work when they got the chance to write the mains. So always remember this thing. One day you will get the chance to write the mains. Do not kill it by simply focusing on prelims. Because that moment, that time, you will only cry. When you will clear the prelims, you will be the most happiest person for 1 or 2 days. And till now, I have interacted with more than 1,000 of students. You will be happy for 2 days. And then you will cry for next 2-3 months. Because their optional was not prepared. They have not done the answer right. They have not prepared for the mains. So I think you have to balance the both. So that is why in this course, intentionally, I have included the answer right. That you must write it. And if you are not writing it, that is the benefit of our institute. Like, suppose you are paying the fee, you are joining it. And if you are not writing, then I don't have to pay to anyone to check your answer. But I don't want that benefit. I want you to feel that, okay, your first answer, second answer would be the worst, third, fourth, more worst. But there will come a time where you will be comfortable to write 150 words, 250 words. And that day, I can tell you, you will be very much happy and you will crave. In this process, as of now, I assume that you are struggling with the prelims. Okay. But when you start writing good answers, when you start writing 250 word answer with proper heading, subheading, then there will be massive craving. There will be massive craving for writing them. And that craving will push you to study even beyond 2 days. To study even beyond 3 days, 4 days, to study even beyond 10 hours. Even in your sleep, you will be craving for writing. But unless you do that, you will be in that crowd which is dying to appear in them. But I want you to go beyond that. That will only come when you will write 2 answers every day. Whatever question we will put to you. And as I'm seeing this post, so this beauty wala, ye galat ho gaya hai. So sorry for that. Okay. Any doubt, any question? Unmute your audio and you can ask the question.
Sir, now how much time we should give to our optional and when we should leave the optional and purely focus on the GS part only?
If I can tell you from my personal experience, optional is of 500 marks. Okay. GS and SA is of 1250 marks. Right?
Okay. Sir. Yes, sir.
But optional require more amount of energy and time to to prepare. Then yes, GS and FA. So ideally before prelims, at least you should have read your optional ones. That is the minimum requirement. I'm not expecting any answer writing or anything from here. But what I'm expecting that, what is your optional?
Sir, Hindi literature.
Hindi literature. Okay. So suppose there is some poet and he has said something. So at least you should know that who is that poet and what he has said. Itna to I can expect from you.
Yes, sir.
But if you are not preparing before the prelims, then there is a possibility you don't even know the name of that poet. You don't even know what he has said.
Yes,
so that
sir.
would be a blunder.
Sir, I have read at least 2 times my optional.
Yeah, so then it is fine. And I think now you should start making the short notes of your optional.
Okay, sir.
Because till March, it is very safe till March. You can prepare for prelims as you have said that you have read books like 4, 5, 6 times. Those who are in their zero or first attempt wala experience, they find it very difficult initially. Yes. But ideally, optional ek baar to padhna chahiye prelims.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any more doubts, guys? Unmute your audio and you can ask the doubts. I hope there are no further doubts. Just last 1 minute, if you have any doubt, feel free to ask. So let's end this session. Okay. And if you have any doubts, then you can message your doubts on SOMP inquiries. Okay, guys. So good night. Bye-bye.